Greetings YouTube, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we'll learn about dividend swaps and other types of swap. Don't forget to watch the video till the end, where I'll tell you how to hit the like and the subscribe buttons. Okay, so today's video is on dividend swaps and other types of swaps, such as commodity swaps and equity swaps. This content is all based on my book, Trading and Pricing Financial Derivatives, which is linked to in the description below. Dividend swaps are a derivative which originated in the early 2000s. They came about due to the popularity of structured products such as equity-linked notes, which became popular in the 1990s. Most equity-linked notes reflect capital appreciation alone and do not include gains from dividends and dividend reinvestment for tax reasons. Investment banks were thus left holding streams of potentially volatile dividend payments to which they wished to hedge their exposure. This gave rise to the dividend swap. A dividend swap is an over-the-counter derivative where the holder of the fixed leg pays the other party a pre-designated fixed payment at each interval in exchange for the total dividends that were paid out by a selected underlying. The underlying can be a single company, a basket of companies, or all of the members of an index. The payments are multiplied by a notional number of shares. Like most swaps, the contract is usually arranged so that its value at signing is zero. This is accomplished by making the value of the fixed leg equal to the value of the floating leg. Thus, the fixed leg will be set at the average expected dividends over the term of the swap for the given underlying. Dividend swaps share some risk similarity to an investment in cash equities, as both involve exchanging a fixed amount of money for a set of uncertain future dividends. A cash equity investment, however, has a much higher dividend duration than the dividend swap, in the same way that a perpetuity has a higher interest rate duration than a fixed maturity bond. Duration being a measure of the sensitivity of the price of a fixed income investment to a change in interest rates. So that is dividend swaps. There are a lot of other types of swap available, as essentially with any two existing cash flows, we can structure a swap to exchange them. Let's look at a few more. Commodity swaps are where a floating or spot price based on an underlying commodity is exchanged for a fixed price over a specified period. No commodities are exchanged during the trade. Equity swaps, where the dividends and capital gains realized on an equity or equity index are exchanged for either a fixed or a floating interest rate. Variance and volatility swaps, which I've done separate videos on and I'll link to those above. Zero coupon swaps, which are of use to corporations who have floating rate liabilities but would like to conserve cash for operational purposes. Interest rate swaps can be arranged on non-LIBOR rates. Currency swaps can be fixed for floating, which are known as cross-currency interest rate swaps, or floating for floating. Principal amounts can reduce over time, which we call amortizing, or they could increase over time, which we call a step-up swap. Sometimes options are embedded in swaps, making them extendable, callable, or puttable. Swaptions are an option giving the right but not the obligation to engage in a swap. There are numerous variations available on the plain vanilla swap structure that are limited only by the imagination and interest of market participants. So that's it on swaps. Don't forget to hit the like button and the subscribe buttons to the channel. Hit the bell button if you would like to be notified every time I release a new video on quantitative finance or derivatives. See you later. Bye.